Hey guys, alright, this is going to be a little quick tour of the Boreham Wood Test Centre. So that's the car park out there. Let me zoom into that and I'm going to go up to that in a second. That's where you guys are going to enter, alright, and that's where you're going to exit as well. So this is the test centre. You're going to walk in here to get you signed up, alright. This is the entrance. It's actually a really nice sort of waiting room here, nice and chilled. And then that's my spot usually over there. Anyway, the examiners will come out from here. If you guys need the toilets, they do have toilets here. Not that you really need a tour of this stuff, but that's... There you go, bathroom facilities. All right, so examiners will come out like this. You guys will be out there waiting. And then they usually use this desk or one of those to sign up on. And then you should go for your test. So you'll start coming out from here. All right. And then you'll exit. And then I'll take a little quick walk up here. All right. Mindful of the road. There you go. So you're checking both sides there. Because it's usually actually quite busy. This is really quiet today. So that's why I thought I'd take the opportunity to quickly give you a quick tour of the car park. So really simple, loads of bays here. If it is this quiet, you can actually be taken here to or start here and do your maneuvers. They've got a little section here for candidates only. See that? So if you are coming up in your own car, then don't park in the rest of the car park. You're only allowed to park up to this little line here, and the rest of it up to there is all for the candidates. Everyone else is for the rest of the building anyway. There's other companies here, so don't park in other bays. Apart from that, you're going to start from here. The barrier automatically opens when you're exiting. It does not close on you, so don't fear that, because some students do fear that. And then that's it, your test will start. You'll be literally leaving from the barrier section there, okay? And then this part is quite busy, so you just make sure you're checking both sides before you leave, all right? Pretty straightforward, and that's about it, really. Hey guys, back at Boreham Wood, and it's a 917 test and absolutely smashed it. Only two minors, one was just for adjusting the forward bay park. I can't remember what the other one was for, but it was such a good drive. And one thing that stood out for me, which is super, super important, generally what I do is at the beginning of a test and a few days before, always give these students a couple of things that they have to remember on the day. And that is, number one, there's three things basically. Number one, if anyone's horning behind you and you're at a junction and it's not safe to go yet, and they're stressing you out behind, just ignore it. So if anyone horns, ignore it, okay? Number two is you have to go according to the lane you are in. So if you pick the wrong lane, or you realize that the other lane is a bit busy to turn into, don't stress out, don't force yourself in, and go according to the lane you are in. And the third rule is, if you feel that you have failed at any moment, ignore that completely. And you're not the judge, that's the examiner's job, leave that to them. Now what the student did is he really applied rule number two. So what happened is, they came up to the Tesco sort of roundabout. Sat-nav was telling them to go straight ahead, or right, I can't remember, but you have to be on the right lane for that. And but when you enter it, you're entering on the left-hand lane. And then what happened is, there were three vans on the right-hand side and student couldn't get into it. So turned around to the examiner and said, look, I can't get into the right lane because of the vans. I'm just going to go left into Tesco's, because the lane on the ground said left only. And the examiner was like, yep, do what you need to do, or do what you're taught to do. And student went into Tesco's, went to the petrol station, came back out, and joined the road correctly. And that is how you do it. It's hard to stay cool and composed under pressure, but absolutely aced it. So I couldn't have been more impressed with that moment especially. Overall, excellent drive. Was a great driver anyway, always spot on driving. Except that the day before had his little moment where a few errors here and there that just came out, and that was good because that keeps you humble, keeps you focused. And then today just proved to everyone how good a driver they are. So have a look. I think the incident which I was referring to is at around 11 minutes or so, 11 and a half minutes, and you'll see that they go into Tesco's and then come out of it. So the route is good, pretty challenging, natural speed limits as well, and but yeah, overall very, very good. Okay, guys, this is the roundabout that we're coming up to the Tesco one soon, and the sat nav is telling you to go left first exit. So student does that, position's fine, goes left first exit, and then what happens is sat nav will tell you to go straight ahead second exit, but it tells you a little bit late, and then by that time the you know it's a bit late to shift over. You can see the black car in the top left hand side, or in the rear view, and they're just coming past. Then there's a van as well, so the student does really well not to shift over. This is a left lane only, and this is where the student turned around and said, you know what, I need to go left. They went into Tesco's, came back out, and then joined like the bus was up there. But really, really impressed with that awareness and calm composure. So it's quite hard to do. But that's golden rule number two. You know, you must go according to the lane you are in and not the direction you've been given. Okay, because as you can see, you go somewhere else, you just, you know, turn the car around, you come back, you just rejoin the road that you need to join. So not hard at all.